Welcome everyone. In episode 4, we're diving deeper into the fascinating world of reconnaissance. This phase is where we gather crucial information about the target system. Throughout this week, we'll explore various types of reconnaissance techniques and the tools needed to execute them effectively. So, let's start with network reconnaissance. We're examining and analyzing the target's network infrastructure, focusing on gathering information about network devices, services, and potential vulnerabilities. Our go-to tool for this is Nmap, a powerful network scanning tool. With Nmap, we can conduct network scans and identify open ports, active services, and even the operating systems running on the target network. Nmap's versatility allows us to employ different scanning techniques like SYN scans, TCP scans, and UDP scans to gather comprehensive data about the target system. If you enjoy this type of content, smash that like button. Network reconnaissance also involves understanding the network topology and mapping the relationships between devices. Tools like Netstat and OpenVOS come into play, providing us with insights into network connections, routing tables, and vulnerability assessments. By combining these tools with Nmap's scan results, we can paint a detailed picture of the target network, identifying potential entry points and weaknesses. Moving on to web reconnaissance, we're diving into the target's web presence, including websites, web applications, and web servers. For this, we're utilizing Recon-ng, an automated information gathering tool. With Recon-ng, we can gather data from various online sources like search engines, social media platforms, and public databases. By aggregating data from multiple sources, we create a comprehensive profile of the target's web assets, identifying potential vulnerabilities and points of entry. Web reconnaissance also involves analyzing website structures, inspecting page source codes, and examining HTTP headers. Tools like Burp Suite and Durbuster aid us in discovering hidden directories, sensitive files, and potential misconfigurations. This meticulous examination allows us to identify security gaps and potential avenues for exploitation. Wireless reconnaissance is another crucial aspect we're exploring. We're gathering information about wireless networks and their security configurations. Tools like Airodump-ng and Kismet are helping us perform wireless network scans. These scans reveal nearby access points, their signal strengths, and encryption methods. Understanding the wireless landscape allows us to assess the security posture of the target network, pinpoint weakly secured access points, and even perform targeted attacks like capturing handshake packets for offline password cracking. By the way, don't forget to download my free ethical hacking toolkit, you'll find the link in the description. Now, let's talk about social engineering. It's all about exploiting human psychology and vulnerabilities to gain unauthorized access or extract sensitive information. Throughout this week, we're exploring advanced techniques like phishing, pretexting, tailgating, and impersonation. We'll also discuss effective defense strategies to fortify our systems and counter social engineering attacks. Social engineering reconnaissance requires us to understand the target's human element. This includes gathering information about employees, their roles, and their online presence. Open source intelligence, OSINT, techniques, such as searching social media platforms, analyzing public records, and examining company websites, aid us in building comprehensive profiles of individuals within the organization. This information becomes valuable when crafting tailored social engineering attacks or implementing robust security awareness training programs. To enhance our reconnaissance efforts, we're leveraging Wireshark for packet analysis. Wireshark helps us capture and analyze network traffic, giving us valuable insights into the communication within the target network. By examining packet payloads, headers, and protocols, we can identify anomalies, detect potential security breaches, and uncover hidden vulnerabilities. Packet analysis also involves the identification of network-based attacks such as DDoS, ARP poisoning, and SQL injection. We employ tools like Snort and BroIDS to monitor network traffic, detect suspicious patterns, and generate alerts for potential threats. This proactive approach strengthens our ability to identify and mitigate security risks during reconnaissance and beyond. Additionally, we're exploring passive reconnaissance techniques. Instead of direct interaction with the target system, we gather information from publicly available sources without raising any alarms. Techniques like open source intelligence, OSINT, gathering and footprinting enable us to map the organization's digital footprint and identify potential areas of vulnerability. During passive reconnaissance, we leverage search engines, public databases, WHOIS records, and social media platforms to collect information about the target. By analyzing historical data, identifying domain ownership, and studying online footprints, we gain valuable insights into the target's infrastructure, technologies used, and potential security weaknesses. This information aids us in creating a comprehensive picture of the target's digital presence, helping us craft effective attack vectors or implement robust defenses. In my next video, I'll progress to system hacking. We'll explore various methods of gaining access to systems, such as brute force attacks, SQL injection, and cross-site scripting. We'll also delve into malware, what it is, how it works, and how it can be used or defended against. This week, you'll get to flex your problem-solving muscles, finding creative ways to exploit vulnerabilities discovered in the previous week. Remember, ethical hacking emphasizes responsible and legal practices to enhance cybersecurity. So, let's dive into this exciting journey of ethical hacking together.